Filipino bookworms are back at it again this National Language Month with Weekathon Year 3. Weekathon is a month-long readathon featuring works of Filipino authors. For more on this and what we can expect this time around, we are joined by Weekathon founder and book blogger Kate Peseta. Good morning, Kate. Thank you for joining us.
Hi, good morning.
All right. So, first off, tell us more about yourself. What is it about our language that you love, and why start Weekathon ultimately?
Yeah, so I'm Kate. I'm a book blogger, and I started blogging in 2018 about books, and I really discovered that what I wanted to do with the platform I had was really to promote Filipino authors. Mm-hmm. And I started Weekathon in 2020.
Amid the pandemic. Mm-hmm.
Yes, it was a pandemic project. I really wanted to do something that would promote Filipino authors of Filipino authors who write in all languages, whether that was English or our own native languages. It is something that I would really like to share, not just with Filipino mm-hmm. audience, but with a worldwide audience of bookworms.
Right. And then as an offshoot of Buwan ng Wika, August is also celebrated as Buwan ng mga Akdang Pinoy, right? And Weekathon has been started last August 1. How's the campaign going?
It's going great. Buwan ng mga Akdang Pinoy was started several years ago by an author named Edgar Calabia Samar. Alongside celebrating Filipino languages, it was really also all about celebrating Filipino creativity. And the campaign has been going really well. The response mm-hmm. it's received has been overwhelming since 2020. Filipino readers have reacted to it positively, have enjoyed seeing books written by authors that are like them, that have the same experience as them, being pushed and promoted, not just by Filipino readers, like I said, but an international mm-hmm. audience. So it's really nice to be able to see writers, authors who look like you, who have the same experiences mm-hmm. as you, being promoted in that way.
And we're already at Weekathon 3, right? It's a third year. Can you tell us more about the previous ones and what makes this year's special? How do you go about Weekathon?
All right. So when I started it in 2020, like I said, it was a pandemic project. Mm-hmm. I didn't really put a lot of thought into thinking about like how the campaign would go, how the readathon would go. So I just came up with random prompts that would help people decide what books to read, like mm-hmm. read a book by a queer Filipino author, read a fantasy novel by a Filipino author, read a book by a Filipino author who is not from a Tagalog province, things like that. And as year two and year three happened, I realized that I wanted to have a cohesive theme or vibe for each year that would make each year, 2020, 2021, and now 2022, stand out. And the standout for this year, for Weekathon 3 year 2022, is that it isn't just about books. The theme is really also including cinema. So the themes are centered around some classic movies from Filipino cinema. So for example, if we have one of the prompts is called Enteng Kabisote, which is a very popular fantasy franchise. And that prompt is for you or the reader to read a Filipino fantasy novel. And aside from the prompts that involve movies, we also have a list of some favorite or upcoming Filipino movies that are must watches or must check out. So it's, aside from books, it's books and cinema. So it's really this overall very, very holistic or cohesive concept of Filipino creativity. Mm-hmm. I still have no idea though what I'm going to do for 2023 and 2024 to top the cinema edition to this year.
It's all right. One year at a time, right? Buwan ng Wika though does not really mean Buwan ng Tagalog, di ba? So how will we be celebrating other dialects as well?
I want to add that I learned this quite some time ago, and I think it isn't that common knowledge yet, but the use of the word dialect is actually not pretty accurate when we're talking mm-hmm. about other languages in the Philippines, such as Bisaya and Hiligaynon, Pangasinense, and so forth. Those are languages, not dialects.
It's a full-on language.
So our dialect would be Yes, it's a full-on language. A dialect would be, I think, for example, I'm not a linguist, so like I am aware that maybe my understanding is not complete, but as I understand it, a dialect would be like the difference between Bulacan Tagalog and Batangas Tagalog, something like that.
Right.
But yeah, it is very important to acknowledge that when we're talking about buwan ng wika, I actually don't use the phrase buwan ng wika. I would prefer to say buwan ng mga wika to acknowledge that, you know, there are over 150 languages present in the Philippines alone. And one little way that Wikathon sort of supports that is that we really do make the effort to remind participants or readers who would like to read Filipino authors to check out works that were written by authors who are not from Tagalog-speaking regions. So one of the prompts for Wikathon is to read a non-Tagalog author, and we provide lists of authors who are from other places, especially places in Visayas and in Mindanao as well.
Right. And going back to what you said earlier, you said that both the film and the book industry are simultaneously a celebration and a responsibility. Care to expound on that statement?
Yeah, so the Filipino film industry, you know, it's a celebration of what Filipinos are capable of, creatively speaking. It's a celebration of what we can do with our imaginations, with our hard work, the products and the stories that we can tell using just our imaginations, our minds. It's amazing, really, what Filipino minds can come up with given just a little bit of time and thought. But it's also a responsibility when we put something out there for public consumption. We have a responsibility to think about how it's going to be received, what it's based on, what message are we sending, what information are we presenting as fact or fiction. So while it is a celebration of what Filipinos are capable of, I'd like to think that it's also a reminder to us of the responsibility, or to creators in general who are putting out products for public consumption. It's a reminder to be mindful of the fact that people, real people out there, are going to be consuming what we create. So we need to always be aware of that and think about that every time we create these books or these movies and put them out there in the world.
And Kate, what's your reaction to President Marcos wanting Filipino to be the language of teaching? Is this the best way to go about this?
Well, I've always believed that speaking English isn't necessarily a sign of education. It's not the be-all and end-all of sounding intelligent. And I do agree that, you know, there does need to be some kind of measure to make sure that fluency in our languages doesn't die out. But what we do need to think about, as I mentioned earlier, we have over 150 languages present in the Philippines. So when you're talking about Filipino being present in schools or being used as the medium of teaching, we do have to think about, when we say Filipino, do we mean the Filipino that's based on Tagalog? Because there are regions, there are cities, there are schools that this is not their main, Tagalog is not their main form of communication. Exactly. So that is something that we do need to think about. It is a good measure. It's a measure that I am personally in favor of. But lawmakers and teachers and the relevant agencies do need to think about that. The fact that Tagalog is only one of over 150 languages spoken in the Philippines.
And following this, in today's world of modernization, globalization, why is it important never to forget our own native language? Bakit mahalagang hindi kalimutan ang sariling wika?
Well, I do like to think about, you know, what Jose Rizal said about, not the one about ang hindi marunong magmahal ng sariling wika, not that one, but what he said about if you're not able to look at and connect with your past, you will never really be able to move forward and seize the future that you have and that is in store for you. Our language, our native languages, are a connection to those who came before us. There are generations, centuries of Filipinos from whom we are descended who spoke these languages. And I think that forgetting those languages and not being able to hold on to those languages does a disservice to how they have managed to maintain fluency of these languages throughout all the years of colonization we've had. You know, I mean, like, we've been colonized by the Spaniards, by the Americans for centuries, for hundreds of years. And despite all of that, despite all of that subjugation, our ancestors managed to keep our languages alive to the point that now, 500 years from 500, 600 years from when Magellan first landed in Cebu, we still speak Bisaya, Tagalog, all of that. And it would be a shame to lose that touch point with our ancestors. You know, it's not everyone who can say that they share something in common with so many generations of people who came before them.
It's para hindi rin tayo maging higit pa sa malansang isda. Kidding. All right, lastly, how can we best jump into this fun initiative and join the community? Where can we get more info about Wikathon?
Well, all the information on Wikathon is available on my blog, yourtitakate.com, and all the social media accounts of Wikathon, at yourtitakate on Twitter and on Instagram. You can get the prompts there, you can get all the information there, you can get lists of books written by Filipino authors from there. So just, you know, it's never too late to start, and even though it's like August 5, you can still join in and keep reading Filipino authors, not just this August, but, you know, the rest of the year as well.
All right. Thank you for your time, Kate Maseta.
Thank you so much for having me.